Rational Team Concert 2012 using the ISPF client. The ISPF client provides an ISPF interface to perform various Rational Team Concert functions. The ISPF client enhancements listed on this slide will be demonstrated in this video. This is an ISPF interface. After logging into a repository connection, we will work with a repository workspace. To navigate between the submenus, type an equal sign and the option number. Here we will navigate to the Workspaces submenu. Use the L action command to load the repository workspace. Specify a dataset prefix and ZOS Unix directory as load locations to indicate where resources will be loaded. Type a slash to see the possible actions for loading a component. This list shows the different loading options. Type a 1 to select the Z component projects to load. It's equivalent to entering the S load action. Type a slash to select the Z component projects to load. Then press the Enter key. Type a 1 to narrow the search for the Z files or files to load. It's equivalent to entering the SF load action. To limit the number of members in a dataset that are displayed, define a pattern of specification. Then press the Enter key. To select the Z files to load, type a slash and press the Enter key. Press the Enter key again to confirm the load. Use the JD action command to open the dataset where the repository workspace is loaded. Enter a member pattern to narrow the list of members that are displayed. Use the E action command to edit the dataset. And use the E action command to edit the member. You can define the edit options in the panel. Here we'll make a change in the source code. Press the F3 key to save the change. This asterisk indicates that a local change is made on the member that we need to check in. Use the C action command to check in the local change. We will create a new work item here. Specify the summary which is required. You can change the default values defined for the fields at the bottom. Press the F3 key to save the work item and exit. The work item is created and associated with the change set. Complete the check-in process by pressing the Enter key. The check-in status says successful and the check-in is complete. Now go to the Workspaces submenu. We use the O action command to view the outgoing change sets. Use the D action command to deliver the change set. Here the deliver message says that it failed. Press the F1 key for more details. In this example, there are conflicts to resolve. Use the I action command to view the incoming change sets. Use the A action to accept the change set. The status shows that the accept is complete. The exclamation point here indicates that the repository workspace contains unresolved conflicts. Type a slash and press the Enter key to see the possible actions. Type an 11 to resolve the conflicts. It's equivalent to entering the C action. Type a slash and press the Enter key to see the possible actions. Type a 3 to compare the local and remote files. It's equivalent to entering the C action. As explained in the notes above, the white lines are from the remote file. Also explained in the notes above, the lines with the label in the left column are from the local file. In this case, merging the changes will resolve the conflicts. Use the MD command to add the lines from the remote file and use the D command to delete the lines from the local file. The final result of the merge is displayed here. Press the Enter key to confirm the merge. Now we'll go back to the Workspaces submenu. Now only the outgoing change sets are ready to be delivered. Use the V action command to view the details of the change set. Use the C action command to compare the changes between the local and remote files. The change seems to be correct. Use the D action command to deliver the change set. Go back to the Workspaces submenu. Now we will edit the last modified member source code. The last change is shown in the local file. Now we will work with unshared files in a dataset. So we will edit a dataset that is not already shared. The question mark indicates that the files are not under source control. Type a slash and press the Enter key to see the possible actions. Type a 3 to share the dataset to a new repository workspace. It's equivalent to entering the SN action. Specify the new repository workspace name and press the Enter key. Type a slash to select the stream where the repository workspace flows and press the Enter key. Type a slash next to New Component, enter a new component name, and press the Enter key. Enter a new Z Component project name and press the Enter key. Type a slash to associate the Z folder with an existing dataset definition shown in the list, then press the Enter key again. You also have the option of specifying the Z file extensions and properties. Press the Enter key again to complete the share process. Now edit the new shared dataset. All files are now under source control with no changes. Go back again to the Workspaces submenu. Use the O action command to view the outgoing change sets. Use the V action command to view the files affected by the change set. The recently shared files are listed here. Use the D action command to deliver the change set. The message indicates the deliver is complete. No changes are pending. To review, we've shown you the Make Primary Options menu, loading a repository workspace at the Z component project and Z file levels, displaying a list of dataset members using a pattern, creating a work item during check-in, comparing and merging from change set details, and sharing files to a new repository workspace. Thank you for watching.